So I've heard that vitamin D is very, very toxic, so you have to be careful about taking too much vitamin D. Well, let me give you the facts on that. It's rare that someone becomes toxic. It's not very common. If I were to summarize the studies on this and even be more conservative, it would take 50,000 to 100,000 international units of vitamin D taken for months to years before you start developing a toxicity. Now, what do I mean toxicity? This is the only toxicity. It's hypercalcemia. It means too much calcium in your blood. What's the big problem with that? A risk of getting kidney stones. Okay, so this is the risk if you take large amounts for months to years. But let's just take a look at the benefits, okay? In the 40s, they did a lot of research on rheumatoid arthritis and other autoimmune diseases, okay? And they were using 200,000 to 300,000 international units of vitamin D every single day with really good results, okay? This is an autoimmune disease. So we have this huge benefit of inflammatory conditions, autoimmune diseases, blood pressure issues, immune support with a rare side effect that could easily be prevented if you were just to consume more water. If you were to drink at least 2.5 liters of fluid, that's 10 cups of water per day, that would bring the risk factor to close to zero of getting kidney stones. You can also lower your risk of kidney stones by not taking calcium supplements, okay? So the point is, number one, most people are not gonna take even 50,000. Maybe they'll take 10,000, 20,000, 30,000, and they might take that for several weeks, but then they maybe go down to 10,000. So they're really not at risk. And if they are concerned, they can just drink more water. So when you're looking at vitamin D, you have to look at not just the risks, but the benefits and weigh them, okay? Because a lot of times the benefits of using higher doses of vitamin D far outweigh the risk factors.